Alright, hello and welcome to Tallinn, Estonia. Estonia, which is an Estonian called EST, officially the Republic of Estonia, EST Vabariik, is a country on the eastern coast of the Baltic Sea in Northern Europe. It is bordered to the north by the Gulf of Finland with Finland, on the other side to the west by the Baltic Sea with Sweden, on the other side to the south by Latvia, and to the east by Lake Peipus and Russia. The territory of Estonia consists of a mainland and 2,222 islands in the Baltic Sea. The territory of Estonia has been inhabited since at least 9000 BC. Ancient Estonians were some of the last European pagans to be Christianized, following the Livonian Crusades in the 13th century. After centuries of successive rule by Germans, Danes, Swedes, Poles, and Russians, a distinct Estonian national identity began to emerge in the 19th and early 20th century. This culminated in independence from Russia in 1920. After a brief war of independence at the end of the World War I, initially democratic, subsequent to the Great Depression, Estonia was governed by authoritarian rule since 1934 during the era of silence. And during World War II, 1939-1945, Estonia was repeatedly contested and occupied by the Soviet Union and Germany, ultimately being incorporated into the Soviet Union and became Estonian Soviet Socialist Republic. So the sovereign state of Estonia is a democratic unitary parliamentary republic right now, divided into 15 counties. Its capital and largest city is Tallinn, that's where we are right now. With a population of 1.3 million, it's one of the least populous members of the European Union, the Eurozone, Schengen area, NATO, and from 2020, the United Nations Security Council. So we are right now walking in the old town. That was a past that you saw. It was a Russian Orthodox church. This is Lithuanian church. So everywhere you walk around Tallinn, you hear mostly Russian language rather than Estonian language. The huge population of Russians concentrated in Estonia made Russian language to be officially basically recognized and considered as a second language. So if you are in supermarket, you are at the airport, the all announcement comes automatically in Estonian and then in Russian language. And so during the Soviet Union breakup, those Russians who stayed here, they didn't go back to Russia. They were born here, they raised here, so they decided to basically continue their life in Estonia. But ultimately, it came to kind of like refusal of learning Estonian language, and that's why Russian language right now is more widely spoken in Estonia, and especially in this capital, Tallinn. You hear Russian more than Estonian. So here we continue walk in our old town and enjoy this beautiful medieval architecture of the beautiful part of the Tallinn, which is the old town. Alright, we are in Tallinn, Estonia, and it's freezing. It's damn so cold, it's unbelievable. With the Gulf of Finland. Well, so far, I am in the old town. Interesting, I would say, but nothing to compare what I saw in Belgium and Luxembourg. So Estonia, it's okay, but gonna enjoy what I have right now, but it's damn cold. I'll never gonna come to Estonia in winter ever again. So we're gonna continue. So Estonia is a developed country with an advanced high income economy that has been among the fastest growing in the European Union. The country ranks very high in the Human Development Index and as well in measures of economic freedom, civil liberties, education, and press freedom. Estonian citizens are provided with universal health care, free education, free transportation, and one of the world's most digitally advanced societies. In 2005, Estonia became the first state to hold elections over the internet, and in 2014, the first to provide electronic residency, which is e-residency. Human settlement in Estonia became possible 13,000 to 11,000 years ago when the ice from the last glacial era melted. The oldest known settlement in Estonia is the Puli settlement, which was on the banks of the river Pärnu near the town of Sindi in southwestern Estonia. So the Bronze Age started around 1800 BC. And in Estonia, then there was a Viking Age. The areas of northern and western Estonia belonged to the Scandinavian cultural sphere during the Viking Age. Estonia was not a unified country during the Viking Age, and the area of ancient Estonia was divided among loosely allied regions. The Viking Age in Estonia is often considered to be part of the Iron Age period, which started around 400 AD and ended around 1200 AD. So the Swedish era of Estonia started in 1558 when the Russian Tsar Ivan the Terrible invaded Livonia and starting the Livonian War. So the Livonian Order was decisively defeated in 1560, prompting Livonian factions to seek foreign protection. The majority of Livonia accepted Polish rule, while rebel and the nobles of northern Estonia swore loyalty to the Swedish king, and the other went to the Danish king. Russian forces gradually conquered the majority of Livonia, but in the late 1570s, the Polish, Lithuanian, and Swedish armies started their own offensives, and the bloody war finally ended in 1583 with Russian defeat. As a result of the war, northern Estonia became Swedish Duchy of Estonia, southern Estonia became Polish Duchy of Livonia, and Saaremaa remained under Danish control. In 1700, the Great Northern War started, and by 1710, the whole of Estonia was conquered by the Russian Empire. The war again devastated the population of Estonia, with 1712 population estimated at only 150,000, 170,000. Russian administration restored all the political and landholding rights of Baltic Germans. The rights of Estonian peasants reached their lowest point, as the serfdom completely dominated agricultural relations during the 18th century. Serfdom was formally abolished in 1816-1819, but this initially had very little practical effect. Majority improvements in rights of the peasantry started with reforms in the mid-19th century. Here we're enjoying the view of the old town. And from the far you can see Baltic Sea. There is a port of Tallinn. And just this magnificent view of the old architecture, this medieval feeling, medieval timing. So when you walk around old town, you just greatly appreciate the history from the past. But because of the weather is so cold and it's so freezing, it doesn't give you much enjoyment to enjoy the city. But you're trying to do your best to enjoy the city, which I did. And I still had some great time, despite of this freezing and cold weather. But anyway, it was great. So we continue walking until we're gonna find the cafe, because I am craving for coffee and some pastry. So in 1917, after February Revolution, in Russia, the governorate of Estonia was expanded to include Estonian-speaking areas of Livonia and was granted autonomy, enabling formation of the Estonian Provincial Assembly. So that's part of Estonia, part of history of Estonia. In April 1919, the Estonian Constituent Assembly was elected, and in 1924, the Soviet Union organized the communist coup d'etat, which quickly failed. Estonia's cultural autonomy law for ethnic minorities, adopted in 1925, is widely recognized as one of the most liberal in the world at that time. And Estonia joined the League of Nations 1921, and attempts to establish a larger alliance together with Finland, Poland, and Latvia failed. And in 1930, Estonia also engaged in secret military cooperation with Finland. Non-aggression pacts were signed with the Soviet Union in 1934 and with Germany in 1939. And in 1938, Estonia declared neutrality, but this provided basically nothing in World War II. So now I'm walking from the old town down on the street and I'm trying to find a cafe, and but I can have a great espresso that I'm craving for a long time, and good cappuccino. And apparently I found the one which is gonna be which happened by accident, and I had really great cup of espresso, absolutely great. It was so balanced, mellow, and not so fruity, not much of the acidity, but it's more kind of neutral flavors, and were really balanced with kind of malty flavor, not of nutty, and touch of caramels, which is really complemented really well. And here we go, that's the cafe caffeine, and we're gonna go inside. So the government of Estonia, or executive branch, is formed by the Prime Minister of Estonia, nominated by the President and approved by the Parliament. The government exercises executive power pursuant to the Constitution of Estonia and the laws of the Republic of Estonia, and consists of 12 ministers, including the Prime Minister. So foreign relations. Estonia was a member of the League of Nations from 22nd September 1921 and became a member of the United Nations on 17th September 1991. Since restoration of independence, Estonia has pursued close relations with the Western countries and has been a member of the NATO since 29th of March 2004, as well as the European Union since May 1st, 2004. In 2007, Estonia joined the Schengen area, and in 2011, the Eurozone. The European Union Agency for Large-Scale IT Systems is based in Tallinn, which started operations at the end of 2012. Estonia held the presidency of the Council of the European Union in the second half of 2017. And since the early 1990s, Estonia has been involved in active trilateral Baltic States cooperation with Latvia and Lithuania, and Nordic Baltic cooperation with the Nordic countries. So here we're gonna go walk a little bit more in Tallinn, Estonia, even though it's so cold, but just to have some glimpse of what Estonia, what Tallinn has to offer. We're right now at the park, and before continuing for some, I will end up at the end at the supermarket for some shopping. So for economy, as a member of the European Union, Estonia is considered a high income economy by the World Bank. The GDP per capita of the country was 29,312 in 2016, according to the International Monetary Fund. Because of its rapid growth, Estonia has often been described as a Baltic tiger besides Lithuania and Latvia. And beginning January 1, 2011, Estonia adopted the euro and became the 17th Eurozone member of state.